BICC Chair, Dr. Mujibur Rahman Mullah, President, Rural Cancer Society, Bangladesh. Special guest, as he claimed, another Mullah, Mullah Ubaidullah Baki, President, Bangladesh Cancer Society. Professor Dr. Abul Qasim, President, Bangladesh Dental Society. Dr. Humayun Kabir Bulbul, General Secretary, Bangladesh Dental Society. Other guests sitting on the dais, distinguished participants from home and abroad, member of the media, ladies and gentlemen, assalamu alaikum and very good afternoon to you all. I am really honored to be present here as the chief guest of today's conference, the conference on Bangladesh Oral Cancer Society. Bangladesh is progressing, but we have challenges also. The challenge of different kinds of diseases. And the health ministry, health sectors as a whole is facing the challenges. The last decade perhaps, the most difficult challenge was the contagious diseases like diarrhea, cholera, measles, etc. But as you know, today the NCDs became more challenging than the contagious diseases. NCDs like cancer, like heart disease, like kidney diseases. And cancer in a single word becoming cancerous. Oral cancer, breast cancer, kidney cancer, there are different types of cancers. And now perhaps it is difficult to find a single family where there is no cancer patient now. So we should be very careful, and ultimately it is our doctors, it is our specialized doctors who will treat this deadly disease. And cancer is a deadly disease, as I know. Up late, of course, we have some treatment for cancer, but for that you need to have early diagnosis that somebody is suffering from cancer. And as it is already presented, that in most of the cases the cancer patients are brought to the hospital at stage 4, from where it is very difficult to treat and to cure that patient. So it is rightly mentioned in this conference already that we should be careful about this disease. So how should we go about it? I want to repeat the proverb: prevention is better than cure. Maybe we should be careful about how to prevent these diseases. And the experts say it's a preventable disease, particularly the oral cancer, because the main causes that are mentioned is the use of tobacco, the betel nut and betel leaves, and other chewing tobacco. So if we refrain from this, these are bad habits in fact. It's rightly mentioned that nowhere in the world these betel nuts and betel leaves and other chewing tobaccos are used, which is used in our country en masse. So if we can make our people aware that these are the causes, main causes of oral cancer, and the people remain abstain from these bad habits, maybe we can save a lot of lives. And for these, we need sort of campaign, some publicity. I'll ask the media people. I find some of the electronic media here. I don't know whether our friends are here. You have a big responsibility, in fact, to tell the people that this oral cancer is preventable by practicing by not taking this tobacco, betel nuts, and other chewing of substance that causes cancer. This is very important. Of course, still there will be cancer, because in one slide, Dr. Mohiuddin Chaudhary, he showed that there are another cause, which is called the age factor. After 40, even if you do not take this tobacco or betel nuts, etc., you might get this disease because of the age factor. So we are at risk. So what is needed? Maybe we can make the make our people aware of the symptoms, whether I am suffering from cancer or not, firstly. Otherwise, if there is no symptom, people will not go to the doctor. So I think this is also a factor which the people should know. What are the symptoms of oral cancer? When should I go to the doctor to consult whether I am suffering from this disease or not? Then the question of only come the question of diagnosis. Proper diagnosis is necessary for proper treatment. Yes, as it is said, the treatment is now available, but you should go to the doctor in proper time. Otherwise, cancer is a deadly disease. It's hardly curable. That if you count at stage 4, it's hardly curable, in fact. So you should come in time. And for this oral cancer, even after the treatment, you need post-intervention management. As it is shown, that your face becomes deformed. So if you need a reconstruction of your face, it's difficult. I'm really happy that I'm here today. I would be rather happier if I could come in the first session. I'm a layman, but as the discussion or as the presentation is about me, it's about the human being. Even if I do not know the terminology used, the doctors who use the terminologies, but I can see the picture. The pictorial presentation is, anyone can understand. This is my face, it's my mouth, it's my tongue, it's my teeth that is shown. So I can understand these things. It was a good presentation. I saw two presentations. So I want to thank at least two presenters here. Major General Mohiuddin, let me congratulate him formally today. He's my classmate in Dhaka College. We have a group called Dhaka College 76. I saw his promotion in our Viber group, and we congratulate him through Viber. But now it's my privilege to congratulate him formally in this conference, that he became the first Major General of Dental Corps in the Bangladesh Army. We are proud of him. And you should be very proud of him, because I don't want to see, I want to say that dental BDS for this reason should be treated as a second class medical education. No. It's as good as any other branch of medical education. In other countries, as I know, I spent time with two countries other than Bangladesh. I spent 1.5 years in Australia. I spent 2 years in America. I saw over there eye and dental must expensive treatment in those countries. That's why the general insurance that you have for your health doesn't cover this eye and dental treatment. But in this country, I don't know why, when I joined this ministry as secretary, I had a sort of feeling, don't take it otherwise, that this dentistry is treated as a second-rate education. This should not be the case. It was a 4-year course. The other medical courses were 5 years. So from this year, it has been made 5 years course. You are as good as any MBBS. And I'm trying to uplift this dental units in 8 medical colleges. We propose a separate code for medical education, dental education, but my deputy secretary yesterday told me that it's not possible because there is a single code for a single college. So I asked him to take it up with the Ministry of Finance so that at least they can allot a sub-head for dental unit so that the dental unit can have their own finance. Let me try. I was amazed by the presentation of Dr. Muzammil Mishraat. I was really amazed that medical education as a whole, in fact, has gone too far. And in dentistry and neck surgery, they are using robotics. It's fantastic. I don't know when we will be getting this technology in our country. I would rather request Dr. Muzammil to come up with this technology to Bangladesh, train our doctors here, so that we can have the latest technology in dental surgery and the maybe next surgery. This is really good. In fact, medical education is a life science. Unlike other branch of education, you cannot finish your education just passing MBBS or BDS. You have to be a student throughout your life. This is a life science. Every day, every month, it's getting changed. The technology is being changed. So you have to have the latest technology at hand to treat your patients. Sorry, I'm taking more time. Today is Friday. Jumma prayer is just within maybe 5 to 10 minutes. Let me finish here just by thanking the organizer here. Thank you. I believe that this seminar, this conference, will be very beneficial for our doctors who are dealing with this oral cancers and other discipline also here, different doctors from different discipline came here. So I think you can share the experiences of the experts who have come from abroad, like Dr. Muzammil and some other doctors from India, Sri Lanka and Japan. You can share the experiences, you can enrich your knowledge and another thing is very important, that whatever you do, you do it together. And Togetherness is very important. We live in a competitive world. So if you want to compete with others, you need unity strength. So be united and try to make your profession the best. With this hope, I want to finish here. Thank you. Thank you very much.